Hello everybody here in Amsterdam North in Studio 150 in the Bethlehemkerk. It's a beautiful location and we are thrilled to play here in this nice acoustics with a nice wooden floor. Sounds really good. We are the Roktet. Roktet consists of 8 string players and this cast is well known for its compositions, which are made by Mendelssohn, for instance, Octet. But today we are going to play less well-known pieces. And we will start with an octet of by Shostakovich. Shostakovich, when he wrote this piece, he was 19 years old and he studied in St. Petersburg. And this is one of his conservatory projects. So his teacher made a lot of corrections when he first gave it to his teacher. But Shostakovich didn't want to change anything and didn't listen to his teacher. And we are actually quite happy about that because it's very modernistic and it doesn't refer to older music. So it's really, really refreshing and new music. He completed this octet in the same period as his first symphony, also a conservatory project, which he finished in 1925. And those pieces were composed in a period where it was relatively free to compose whatever you wanted, because it was in the last days of the authority of Lenin, and he was not so strict. But later, Stalin became the ruler, and under his authority it was not possible to be so modernistic and modern. Actually this piece which we're going to play now was forbidden in 1948 because it was too much for the elite and not for the common working man. It hasn't been played until 1960, and so it's not well known for that reason. Shostakovich dedicated this piece to his friend Vladimir Kurchevov. He was a poet, and he just died when he started composing this piece, so he committed him to him. And it has 2 movements. The first movement is a prelude, and the second movement is a very very fleeting and sarcastic scherzo, really Shostakovich-like. I hope you enjoy this wonderful piece.
Thank you. So I wanted to tell you a little bit about our ensemble. We have been together for 4.5 years, and it started actually as a fun party of I invited some friends to give a concert together, to play octet together, because it was actually my dream to play octet, because my parents had an amateur octet and they had so much fun. All their holidays they were playing this beautiful music for octet. And I was a bit jealous with lots of parties and wine and stuff. So I decided I would ask my friends in the orchestra, in the Netherlands Radio Philharmonic Orchestra. This orchestra is actually this week, exists 75 years. So I asked the people, and I thought it would be one concert, but we enjoyed it so much that we played again after a year. And then, you know, it got out of hand a bit. So we actually also made a CD together. And on this CD, you can also listen to these two pieces that we played tonight.
Yes. No, I just wanted to show our CD. If you recognize it somewhere, that's us. With works of Shostakovich, Afanasyev, and Mendelssohn, octets.
That's it. That's right. And we had a great time recording this. And I wanted to tell you a little bit about the next piece that we are going to play for you by Nikolai Afanasyev, because he's really not well known here in Europe and seldomly heard also. There's one piece by him that's a little bit more known. This is the Volga Quartet. He got a prize for that. But he wrote about 350 pieces in his life. And he was actually a very special person. He was born in Siberia in 1821. And because there were no teachers, violin or music, his father taught him everything. And he was an excellent violinist. When he was 17, he got actually won the audition to be concertmaster in Moscow. And he had to go to Moscow, this 2,300 kilometers from the place where he lived, Tobolsk, in Siberia. So that was, I don't know, I don't think he ever came back there because he got really famous and he made lots of tours through Russia and Georgia and Ukraine. And also a few years later, he went through Europe. And all this, I think, in a carriage with horses. I don't know, he must have loved to travel. And also he was very popular as a violinist. He also composed already by then, but he decided, I think, in 1946, he decided to do only be a composer. From then on, he made most of his compositions, and he also has some books with children's songs. There are symphonies, there are all kinds of pieces that nobody ever hears. And one of them is this double quartet. That's why we just changed our positions, because this piece is actually a double quartet. And we will play it now for you. There are lots of Russian elements, folk music, more dance rhythms, and I hope really that you will enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you.